We're given the function f of x equals x to the fifth times the quantity x plus 6 raised to the fourth on the closed interval from negative 8 to 2. Number one, we want to determine the critical numbers. Number two, we want to determine the open intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing on the closed interval. Number three, find the open interval for which the function is positive. And finally, number four, find the absolute extrema on the closed interval from negative 8 to 2. We'll begin by determining the critical numbers, which is where the first derivative will be equal to 0 or undefined. So we'll begin by finding the derivative function. Notice how we have to apply the product rule to find the derivative function, where f prime of x would be equal to the first function, x to the fifth, times the derivative of the second function, which would be the derivative of the quantity x plus 6 raised to the fourth, plus the second function, the quantity x plus 6 to the fourth, times the derivative of the first function, which would be the derivative of x to the fifth. So now we'll find the derivative here and here and begin to simplify. The derivative of the quantity x plus 6 raised to the fourth, notice how we do have an inner function where the inner function u would be equal to x plus 6. So the derivative would be 4 times u to the third times u prime, or 4 times x plus 6 to the third. But notice the derivative of x plus 6 would just be 1. Then we have plus the quantity x plus 6 to the fourth times the derivative of x to the fifth, that would be 5x to the fourth. So simplifying, we have 4x to the fifth times the quantity x plus 6 to the third plus 5x to the fourth times the quantity x plus 6 to the fourth. And now let's factor the greatest common factor from these two products. Notice how there are 4 factors of x common and 3 factors of x plus 6 common. So looking at the first term, notice how this would leave us with just 4x. Plus the second term, we'd have a factor of 5 and one factor of x plus 6. So now we have x to the fourth times the quantity x plus 6 to the third times, this would be 4x plus 5x plus 30, or 9x plus 30. But notice how this binomial factor has a common factor of 3, so go ahead and factor a 3 out. So our final derivative function would be 3x to the fourth times the quantity x plus 6 to the third times, factoring 3 out of 9x plus 30 would leave us with 3x plus 10. Well, notice how this derivative function is never undefined. So to find the critical numbers, we'll set this equal to 0 and solve for x. Notice how this would be equal to 0 when x equals 0, or when x plus 6 equals 0, or when 3x plus 10 equals 0. So here, x equals negative 6. Here we subtract 10 divided by 3, x equals negative 10 thirds. So we have 3 critical numbers. X equals negative 6, x equals negative 10 thirds, and x equals 0. So now we'll use these critical numbers to divide up the interval from negative 8 to 2 to determine where the function is increasing or decreasing. And to save some time, I've already done some of this work, where if we start with the open interval from negative 8 to 2 and use the critical numbers, where the smallest critical number was negative 6 here, the next critical number was negative 10 thirds, which would be here, and then finally we have a critical number of 0. Notice how by using these critical numbers, we have 4 intervals to test the sign of the first derivative. So starting at the left, we'll use the x value of negative 7 to test the sign of the first derivative. For the next interval, we use the test value of x equals negative 5. For this interval, we use x equals negative 1. And finally, we'll use x equals 1. To save some time, I've already evaluated the first derivative function at these test values. Again, here's our derivative function below, so I already performed the substitution for these inputs to determine these outputs. Notice when x equals negative 7, the first derivative is positive. For x equals negative 5, it's negative. For x equals negative 1, it's positive. And for x equals 1, it's also positive. So where the first derivative is positive, the function is increasing over the interval, and where the first derivative is negative, the function is decreasing over the interval. So it's increasing over this interval, decreasing over this interval, and increasing over these last two intervals. So in this example, when given the intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing, we do have to be a little careful. The function is increasing on the open interval from negative 8 to negative 6, but then notice how it's increasing over both of these intervals, and so we'll combine these and say it's increasing on the open interval from negative 10 thirds all the way to 2. And then it's decreasing on the open interval from negative 6 to negative 10 thirds. Now it doesn't ask, but notice how at x equals negative 6, the function changes from increasing to decreasing. So we'd have a relative maximum at x equals 6. And then at x equals negative 10 thirds, the function changes from decreasing to increasing. And therefore we'd have a low point or relative minimum at x equals negative 10 thirds. Now we want to find the interval for which the function is positive, which should be the interval where the function is above the x-axis. To do this, let's analyze the graph. Looking at the graph of the function, notice how the function is only positive over here on the right, or it's above the x-axis. And it may look like it would be positive on the interval from 1 to 2. Remember, we just found that the function is increasing on the open interval from 0 to 2, and therefore the function is above the x-axis, and therefore positive on the interval from 0 to 2, where the interval is open on 0, because the function value would be 0 there. We are going to include the endpoint of 2, though, because we can see f of 2 would be positive, which means the function is positive on the interval from 0 to 2, where the interval is open on 0 and closed on 2. And now for the last question, we're asked to determine the absolute extrema on the closed interval from negative 8 to 2. When determining the absolute extrema, or global extrema, on a closed interval, we need to evaluate the function at the critical numbers, which in our case, they were negative 6, negative 10 thirds, and 0, which we see here, but also at the endpoints of negative 8 and positive 2, which we see here. Once we find these five function values, the largest function value is the absolute maximum, and the smallest function value is the absolute minimum. So notice how this would be the smallest function value, negative 524,288, which would be the absolute minimum, and the largest function value is 131,072, and therefore this should be our absolute maximum on this closed interval. So the absolute max, or just the maximum, is 131,072 at x equals 2. And the absolute minimum, or we can just say the minimum, is negative 524,288 at x equals negative 8. Let's go back to the graph and verify this information. First, let's talk about whether the function is increasing or decreasing. Notice on the open interval from negative 8 to negative 6, the function is increasing. And then on the open interval from negative 6 to negative 10 thirds here, the function is decreasing. Then from negative 10 thirds to 0, the function is increasing. And then from 0 to 2, it also increases. And then for the absolute maximum, notice how on the closed interval, this is the largest function value. Verifying the absolute max does occur at x equals 2. And this would be the smallest function value on the closed interval. Verifying the absolute minimum does occur at negative 8. I hope you found this helpful.